So now we go to the bottoming out patterns. Now this is something where we will try to focus only on two specific patterns which are seen multiple times. There can be multiple ways bottoms can happen, but these are the two things which we've seen work out almost 60 to 80% of the bottoms over the last many, many years. So the first one is what we call as a falling wedge or a triangle. Now what happens in a falling wedge is you're making lower tops, but they are not lower tops as well as lower bottoms. The only difference is the lower bottoms are not very sharp. So for example, you've fallen from 100 to 90, then you go back to 98, then you go down to 88, then you again go back to 97. So the point is every time a new low is made, so you're taking a 2% downtick, but an 8 to 10% bounce back. So the bounce backs are really large in that period. So this is classical bottoming out phase where the markets are falling but not able to fall off sharply. Ideally in a bear market, what happens? You go down, go a little bit up and sharply fall down. So this is the falling wedge or an accumulation phase which happens right at the bottoming out. So let us see it with example, it will become clear. So this is 2008. If you notice, we've gone down 55-60%. This is the sharp fall. In this period, almost same bottoms if you were to look at the closing prices, but there is lower tops here. So this is a classical triangle being formed. Once we cross above this upper end, that is the start of a bottoming out pattern being completed and start of a new trend. So out here, when do you know it is forming? When the bottoms are not really sharp. If you look at this period before that, every time the bottom broke, it fell off sharply. Bottom broke, fell off sharply. But out here, suddenly, it is not sharp. And then you get a massive rally, and this is the start of the new trend. Now you'll see this happening again. This was 2008. Now you'll see this happening again in 2011. Now a good correction has already taken place. The last bottom breaks, it falls. Now there are almost 3 to 4 bunched bottoms here, which are not very, very different or very, very apart. But the bounce backs are really sharp. So this is what we create. It creates that situation wherein somebody who's short continues to think now the market will fall really sharp, but the bounce back takes off the stop losses. And finally, by the third, fourth time, when it is starting to rally up, the shorts get trapped because now they think every time the market bounces, it will again fall back to the lows. But then it takes a one-way move, which is what happens here. So it goes up from 4,500 to 5,600 in no time. So this is an indication of a bottom being in place. Now, the other pattern, so this is falling wedges, which happen, say, sometimes. But the other pattern which we've seen is much more prevalent. It's called the double bottom. And this is what we are seeing in the Nifty for multiple times over the last few years. So let us take this example in 2016. Nifty has fallen from 9,000 to 7,000 odd roughly. A bottom goes back a little bit, makes the same bottom around that 6860 mark. So what do we wait for? Two bottoms to be done and the interim highs to be taken out. So for example, you fall from 100 to 90, go back to 100, then fall to 90. And then when you again cross back 100, that's a confirmation that the double bottom is in place. So you're not buying at the bottoms, you're waiting for a confirmation. So two bottoms are done, and then you get a confirmation above that interim high that tells you the bottoming is done and now we are starting a trend. Same way, if you look at it here again in 2017, we fall during that US elections as well as demonetization. We fall to 8,000, bounce back a little, again fall to the same prices, and then when we cross that interim high at 8,300, 8,400, that's the start of a new trend. Now, what is interesting when we look at double bottoms is when the bottoms are made, it is very tough to visualize that the trend will continue because you will get the confirmation signal, the interim highs being crossed, but it is tough to visualize the new trend. So simply put, you need to keep it just to the pattern. Confirmation is done, then ride on till the time it makes on higher tops and higher bottoms. Again, you'll notice same bottoms here. Out here, 2019, exactly the same bottoms. You got a nice breakout. This was also the day when there was this corporate tax rate cut and we got a nice bump up, retest of the same and then went up. So this was 2019. Now this is the fall which came out of nowhere in 2020. But if you look at this period, nice double bottoms out here. We've seen this happen even in 2010, in 2011, 2012. So we had this bottom at closer to 4,800 in 2011. Same bottoms and then a rally again. So a classical double bottom is simple to see and it works really well. Now, the next pattern which we look out for is bottoming out patterns will tell you the Nifty is done. The next topic is what we call as panic divergences. Now, this is where we say, like we saw on the top, what did we see is when we were talking about Dow theory, the Nifty is struggling, the small cap is going crazy. That is euphoria. What is a panic divergence? Exactly the opposite. The Nifty is not falling a lot, but the small cap is falling sharply. So this is the point of extreme pessimism, right? Very opposite to the top side. On the top, you have small caps going crazy on the upside. On the bottom, it is small caps going crazy on the downside. So let us look at an example. It will become easy. This is 2008. There are two charts in front of you. The bottom one is Nifty. The top one is the small cap index. Now, what do you see? This is a closing price chart. Now, this is the bottom in October, bottom in November, somewhere closer here in Jan, the bottom, and in March. All the bottoms are almost very similar. But what is happening to the BSE small cap index? It keeps on making lower bottoms and it has fallen a good 10-15%, whereas the Nifty has not fallen. So this is where already the index has fallen 65%. It falls off another 10%. And this is the panic part of it. This is extreme pessimism, where the Nifty has started stalling, but the small cap continues to make newer lows. Then after this divergence is done, when you start making the new highs, that is your confirmation the trend has started. So this is your first indication the bottom is getting being formed, wherein small caps start diverging. Now look at this very similar thing happened in 2013. Out here between 2013, you have this same bottoms for a period of almost 6 to 8 months. This bottom here in August 2013 is marginally lower than this previous bottom. But the small cap index is a sharp downtick. And the worst part is the BSE small cap index, which did not recover in 2012, goes on to break the 2011 lows. So that is the point of extreme pessimism, which is where it's actually making a 2 to 3 year bottom. Whereas from the bottom of 2011, your Nifty is up almost from 4500 to 5100. So it's up 15%. This has fallen off much below the 4500 mark. So that was the point of time it signaled extreme pessimism, very similar to the extreme optimism of 2007. What happens between 2013 to 2018? We almost get a 3x to 4x move in the small cap index. And you got some of the best moves in that period. So what does it tell you? What do you have to look out for? Almost a flatter Nifty or slightly drifting, but the small caps just falling off a cliff. You need not be buying exactly in those periods, but that is the point of time you start getting ready for the next cycle. Now, it's not going to work all the times, right? So this is what the markets are. You will have a setup which may not work exactly the same way every time. So this is what happened in 2018. Nifty makes a higher bottom. The small cap index continues to make lower bottoms. So classical divergence. What happens next? You see a good rally in the Nifty as well as the small cap. But then again it falls. So this was a tough one. This is where you could get trapped. Because you got a classical divergence. There was a bounce but it flopped. And the whole markets also fell. The next time again in 2019, you have a higher bottom on the Nifty. And you have a almost a little lower bottom on the BSE small cap. This also worked up really fine. It actually went up a good 20%, then fell in 2020, which was not in your control. But what does it tell you? Simply look out for those divergences. That will generally be an end of the bear market. So it will give you a very strong signal. Now is the time for small caps. And what will happen in this period is valuations will be super cheap. The scenarios will be terrible. So it will be tough to buy in those times. But once you've understood this pattern and when the reversal happens, you are able to participate really, really well. So what are we looking out for? The two criteria where we want out bottoming. First is bottoming out patterns like falling wedges, double bottoms, and a panic divergence in the BSE small cap index to the Nifty. Then the last parameter which you look out for bottoming out is where we try to compare markets, bear markets through RSI as well as market breadth. So that is what we'll take in the next topic.